Today's episode is brought to you by Filter Easy. As you're about to find out, the home is a battlefield with germs, dust, and tiny insects such as mites constantly assaulting your body and immune system. That's not bad enough. Research has consistently shown that indoor air is often far more polluted than outdoor air, with smoke, fungal spores, and chemicals from certain paints, varnishes, and cleaners all being harmful to human health, especially for the elderly or vulnerable, such as children and newborns. Thankfully, Filter Easy can help you retake your home from all the pollutants plaguing it. Its high-quality air filters are made right here in the USA, and shipping is always free. With no commitments or contracts, you're not tied down or obligated, and you're free to try them out for yourself. Upgrade your filters today, just click the link in the description. Now, let's get to the main part of our video. We never expect an accident to happen at home, until it does. But why do these accidents catch us by surprise? The home is where we feel safest, and maybe we let our guard down. However, a millisecond of complacency can lead to a lifetime of pain. In the UK in 2007, almost 2.7 million people were injured at home. In the USA, accidents are the number one cause of death for children and young adults, and almost half of these accidents happened in the home, according to the National Safety Council. Studies by the NSA show that while accidents can happen in all of our rooms, one room is potentially more deadly than all of the others. Can you guess which room that is? That's what we'll find out today in this episode of the Infographic Show, The Most Dangerous Places in the Home. Not all homes are equal. Each home will have its own catalog of risk factors, depending on where it is, how it was built, how well it is maintained, and the age and awareness of the occupants. For example, an apartment on the 30th floor may have a dangerous balcony, and a country home may have a rapid river flowing through the garden. Children and the elderly are obviously more at risk for accidents than the middle-aged. A mentally ill, depressed, or drug-addicted occupant has an even higher accident risk. The National Safety Council states that there were 33,000 deaths and 8 million serious injuries that happened in the home in 2002. That's one death every 16 minutes and one serious injury every 4 seconds for that year. The leading causes of death and suffering in the home are falling over, toxins, suffocation, and smoke inhalation. Poisoning alone caused the deaths of 12,500 people in 2002 in the United States, so watch out what you ingest while rifling through that medicine cabinet. Number 5. The bedroom. This is probably the safest room in the home, but babies do die from accidental crib death. If firearms are kept in the bedroom, the risk of that room being the most dangerous is multiplied dramatically. Electrical fires can occur in any of the rooms using electrical equipment, and the bedroom is no exception. Number 4. The living room. This room is reasonably safe, with rugs, sofas, and no real immediate hazards. However, what might seem harmless enough could be a killer. The sharp corner of a coffee table might become a deadly weapon if you fall down headfirst on it. The accident risk goes up if one is a smoker and has a tendency to fall asleep while smoking in a flammable armchair. Temporary ornamentations, such as a Christmas tree, can occasion festive hazards with all those electric cables, which are often cheaply made, hanging around a flammable tree. One electrical short or an overloaded socket, and that dried out pine tree covered with paper decorations can easily catch fire and gift the residents with a Christmas they will never forget. Then there's number 3, the garden and the garage. Power tools and lawnmowers can be deadly in incompetent hands. Make sure you have power breakers installed. Lawnmower-related deaths account for 0.09 deaths in 1 million deaths in the USA. The country with the most lawnmower-related deaths is Moldova, with 0.45 per 1 million deaths. Number 2. The kitchen. The kitchen can be a dangerous place when the stove is burning. Burning oil left in a pan can be a potential disaster, causing what the British call chip fat fires. These fires can spread through the home fast. When oil heats up, it can catch on fire fast and be difficult to put out. A wet cloth or tea towel is the best remedy for a pan full of burning oil. Turn off the heat and control the flames with a wet rag. Throwing water on the grease fire may only spread it. Beware of boiling water too. More than 100,000 people in the US every year go to the emergency room due to scalding injuries. Hot water causes more than 34 deaths each year. Then there's the danger of leaving appliances with the gas turned on and expiring from the fumes or the exposed naked flame. The kitchen is full of other disasters waiting to happen. In the kitchen, you'll find enough chemicals and cleaning fluids to satisfy any proficient poisoner. These need to be kept out of the reach of inquisitive children. Then you have knives and sharp objects aplenty. Heavy pans in overhead cabinets and slippery floors due to cooking grease spillage can also cause your kitchen to become a potential death trap. Then there are those tiny and invisible killers, bacteria in uncooked meat, can spread onto uncooked food such as salads. Bacteria also breeds in cleaning sponges and cloths. They usually only cause infections and stomach problems, but bacterial infections can be serious for the very young, very old, or pregnant women. Keep your kitchen clean and tidy, and watch your stove while cooking. So, what's the most dangerous room in the house? While the kitchen can be a fire disaster waiting to happen, it turns out the riskiest room in the house is actually at number one, the bathroom. According to the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, each year, around 235,000 people in the United States over the age of 15 visit emergency rooms because of bathroom-related injuries. About 14% of those are admitted for an overnight stay. A third of these injuries happen while bathing or showering. You can slip, fall, and die in the bathtub, making this the most dangerous place in the home. But that isn't all. You have a whole plethora of sharp objects like razors, scissors, and tweezers in the bathroom. This room is where the over-the-counter medicines and prescription drugs are stored, along with super-strength cleaning products and hair dye. Medicine misuse accounts for around 500,000 poisonings each year in the US. Bleach and ammonia mixed together can create a deadly gas. Peroxide used for hair coloring can be used to manufacture deadly bombs. Whatever you do, keep those electric devices out of the bathroom. A radio or a hairdryer falling into the tub with you in it is a sure fast track to the pearly gates, if not an impossibly easy way to pick up some shocking first-degree injuries. So, what's the most dangerous accident you've ever had at home? And is the bathroom really the most dangerous room in the house? Let us know in the comments. Also, be sure to watch our other video called Sleep in Less Than a Minute. Thanks for watching, and as always, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. See you next time!